Hello friends, welcome back to next one. In earlier session, we have discussed how to automate GET request. But the thing is, we haven't used utilities whatever we have developed. So we have only used here API path. We have not used how to get data from property file or how to run RKS in multiple environments. In this session, we are going to discuss how to implement all the utilities while we are automating our APIs real times. And even in this video, we are going to discuss how to assert the data. So whatever response we are getting, we need to assert and we need to make sure we are getting the correct response. So what we are going to do, we are going to discuss how we can assert the data using JSON array or JSON object, however we are getting the data. And we will be using all the utility class, whatever we have developed. Before moving forward, please subscribe Fundo Tester to get more videos on REST API automation framework. So let's get started. So here I have used API path. Now the thing is, for this GET API, we no need to use any parameter. In base test class, we have used a hard-coded base URI. If you are running our test in different environment, let's say dev environment or staging environment, it won't work, or otherwise we have to change the base URI multiple times. So what we are going to do, instead of putting here, we are going to put this base URL into property file. So in inputs, we have created multiple property file. If you didn't watch earlier video, please go to the playlist and please refer. So I have to define here the server URL. Now this data will come from the file and environment util. So I am picking this URL from here. So what I have to mention here, instead of passing hard-coded value, so I have to just call that utility method. So file environment utils dot environment and file dot get, we need to pass particular key. So here my key will be server URL. So whatever we are fetching the value, this will be my key. So I have to use this server URL. So in base test, I have to pass this my server URL. And now I have to run my test. So how I can run? So here in base test, in file environment, we are setting the system property. So we need to pass as a VM argument. So we are going to run for dev environment. So how we can do? We need to just simply run this test, run as, and we need to set a run configuration. So run for setting the run configuration, we need to go to the test ng class and we need to select valid framework and valid test. So my test will be here, get API test, and as a VM arguments, we need to pass -denv is equal to dev. So if you are running for dev environment, then we have to use dev, otherwise QA or staging we can do. So first let me try with dev environment and I'm going to run my test. So my test is running. We are running test, but the thing is, we are getting java.net.connection-exception. So we are getting exception as a connection exception, and which is called connection refused. Why we are getting this exception? Because the thing is, REST assured is trying to connect to our API or endpoint. So whatever API we are using, so let's say this is my API up to dev and my endpoint is, this is my endpoint. So we are hitting on this API, but we are getting connection refused. That means REST assured is not able to reach to the server. So before running my test, I have to make sure my server is up and running or your system is connected with the internet. In this case, you have to check these things. So what I have to do, I have to first start my server. So I have to go to terminal and I have to start my server. So my server is up and running now. So now if I am going to run this test, so I will get a valid response. So again, run configuration, I have to select valid class, arguments, and I have to pass -denv is equal to dev. So if I am going to run it again, we can see here, we'll get a success message here. So it is running. Yeah. So now this time our test is passed and we are getting this response. Now let me try with another environment. So let me try with the staging environment. In staging environment, I have given wrong server URL. And we'll see we are getting those data or not. So what I'm going to do before, in my base test, I'm putting print statement so I can make sure whatever data I'm getting. So this is my, and let me concatenate with this one. So now we have used print statement, so we will see what data we are getting. So let me run it again for staging, and staging make sure you are passing correct VM arguments. So in file and environment, for staging environment, we have used the word called staging. So even spelling should be correct. If spelling is not correct, then we will get null pointer exception. So base, I have to go to my test, run it, run configuration, and I have to pass argument as a staging and run. So my test is running and will get some exception. Unknown host exception means server is trying to reach, or REST assured is trying to reach particular endpoint, but it is not able to reach. So that's why we are getting null pointer unable host, unknown host exception. And we can see here it has printed our server URL, whatever we have mentioned in the staging properties. And one more thing, let's say we have passed invalid arguments. So in this case, what will happen? So let me run it again and we'll give some random word. So instead of staging, I'm give random word, or random, whatever we have not defined in the file and environment file. So in this case, again, we are going to get exception. So my test is running and we are getting exception as a illegal argument. Exception, base URL cannot be null. So we are passing base URL as a null. In this case, we are getting this argument because in random word, which is not available in file and environment. So you have to make sure you are passing correct param there. So now we understand how we can run our test. Now the thing is, we need to validate this response. So before going to, so here we are getting this response. So now we want to validate our status code, even the whatever response we are getting as a utility file. So to validate response, we should have two more libraries. So one is JSON and one we are going to use with this JSON. So these two are available in the Maven repository. If you haven't added this library, you must have added, otherwise you cannot validate your response. First, we need to understand our response is a JSON object or JSON errors. If you go to this site, this is the official document of the JSON media application / JSON media type. You can see here, this is the example of the JSON object. So JSON object always start with the flower braces and ends with the flower braces. So do not consider these two lines, but if you can go to the actual response or sample data, it is started with flower braces and ending with the flower braces. So this is your JSON object, and there is another object which is JSON array. JSON array always start with the square bracket and ends with the square bracket. So you need to understand first, this is your JSON object or JSON array. In simple example, I'll show you one image so you will have fair idea. Yeah. So if it is your JSON object, it start with the flower braces and end with the flower braces. In between these two braces, there will be different types of value. And JSON array start with always square bracket and end with the square bracket. So first you need to understand. So in this case, our case, our responses also start with the square bracket, means it is JSON array. So now we need to validate JSON array. So how we can do that? So first, we need to write JSON array. Yeah, so we have used two utilities. One is org.json and one is Google JSON. So we are going to use org JSON. JSON array is equal to new JSON array. And in this, we have to pass our response as a string. So this is my response dot get body. We are going to use only body, so get body dot a string. So first what we have to do, we have to convert our response in a JSON array. So now this line going to convert our response in JSON array. After that we need to loop through entire response. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than array dot length and I plus plus. And if you are going to print this entire response, so it is print in a 1x1 array element, array index. So let me comment out this code. I have to write array dot get index of I. So we are going to get two values here, because in our response we have two values. One is this one, this is my first element, and this id 7, it is my second element. So if I am going to run this test, so I can see here there are two different element I am going to print. Now the thing is, we need to validate some values. Let's say I want to validate author or title. Based on index also we want to validate these values, because we are not going to validate entire element. So let's say two or three values pairs are there, but real time, let's say we have 1000 values or 500 values, so we are going to validate some values. Let me comment out this code, and again we need to convert this JSON array into JSON object. So whatever element is there, so small element, so if we can go again, if you go to the documentation, so my JSON object start with the flower braces, and this my element again starting with the flower braces. So I can convert this element into a JSON object. I have to write JSON object obj is equal to array dot get JSON object and index I, and then I have to get particular value. So let's say I wanted to get author name, so obj dot get string, and I have to pass the string. So my string value is title. So let's say I want to validate title, so I am going to validate this, and we are going to print this value. So I have to add inside the print statement. So if I am going to run this class, so I'll get two values, one is JSON server and one is Fundo testers. So let me run this. Yes, so we are getting two values, JSON server and Fundo tester. So this is how we are going to validate the data from the response. Let's say this is only my one API. Now I have multiple APIs, so I want to validate for all the APIs. So let's say this is my get validate test, this is my valid test, let's say for example this is my invalid test, and I am going to hit the same API. So what I am going to do, I am going to validate the same thing for the another API is. Let me run this. Yes, so we are able to get JSON server, Fundo tester, again JSON server and Fundo tester. So this is how we need to write the same duplicate code for the multiple APIs. So is it correct way to do or not? So definitely it is not correct way, because this 5 or 6 line we are going to write a multiple time. Again, based on the response you have to define this, you have to write these lines. If you are getting as a JSON object, so you have to, based on that you have to write this, add this data into extent report. So this is my extent report, and we have extended extent report here, so we can simply log here. So I have comment out this second method. So first what I am going to do, test dot log, log status dot info, and here I am going to write my test is starting. After that I am going to print entire JSON body in my extent report. So test dot log, log status dot info, and I want to print my entire JSON body in my report. So I can write, now I want to log status code, cookies or time. So simply I can test dot log, log status dot info, and I can print status code. So here we can write my status code is, and we can concatenate with this one, then again test dot log, log status dot info, response time is, and I want to concatenate this. And last thing is I want to add this into my extend report. So here also I can write test.log log status.info validated values are, and I have to add this line. And end of the test I am writing test.log log status.pass my test is pass, and similar way my test is ended. My test is starting in my state is end. So this is how works. So let me run this so we can get nice report after running our successful test. So let me run it. So my test is pass, and I have to refresh the project, refresh. So in test output folder we will get report. So let me open with the web browser. Yes, so this is my report. I am logging the same information I'll get here. So my test is starting, then we have logged the entire response, my status code, response time, whatever value we have validated. So all these things comes here, and then end of the test I have validated my test is pass and my test is ended. So this is how end-to-end flow works. So in next session what we are going to do, instead of writing this redundant code, we'll read out this codes and we are going to build a utilities for this. So using utilities we are going to validate all this stuff: response, status code, cookies, time. So this is basic validations. So we are going to develop the utilities in next session. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching.